The continuous probability distribution. So let us recall a discrete random variable first. A discrete random variable is one whose possible value either constitute a finite set or else it can be listed in a infinite sequence. For example, if we tossing that random experiment is tossing two coins simultaneously and x denote number of heads, then x can take the value number of, if we toss two coins either both tails, then x number of heads is 0, 1 or 2. So here x takes the value of 0, 1, 2. That means it's a finite set. Therefore, this is an example for discrete random variable. Now, a random variable whose set possibly possible set of all possible value or possible outcomes is an entire number of an interval is not discrete. Such a random variable are called a continuous random variable. For example, if we consider if in a study of the ecology of a lake, we make depth measurement at randomly chosen locations. Okay, so in this study of ecology of lake, we will find or make depth measurement at randomly. If we denote x is the depth at such a location is a continuous random variable. That means the water level may be at any value between some interval. Okay, so depth measurement we can that must be a that would be a continuous random variable. So definition of so in case of probably discrete random variable, there is probability mass function. Similarly, in continuous random variable, it is discrete probability density function, or we call it a probability distribution function. So let us define what is probability density function. Let x be a continuous random variable, then a probability distribution or probability density function, we denote it by PDF of x is a function f of x such that any two numbers a and b, where a less than or equal to b, probability of a less than or equal to x less than or equal to b is integral a to b f of x dx. That means probability between a and b is we will integrate f of x dx. For example, so this is a, this is b, then p of x less than or equal to b is the area under the curve. Okay, so we studied few properties in discrete random variable. Discrete random variable properties, we studied that PMF is always greater than or equal to 0 and sum of Px over f of x is total sum is 1. Similarly here, if f of x is a PDF, then f of x is always greater than or equal to 0. And also second property, integral minus infinity to infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. That is total integral is 1. Now we will define what is cumulative distribution function. So let us recall what is cumulative distribution function. The cumulative distribution function is same what we done in discrete random variable. It is denoted by capital X f of x. For a continuous random variable is defined by, for every number x, f of x is, capital F of x is p of x less than or equal to x, that is integral minus infinity to x f of y dy. So now I will define expectation of x or mean. Mean is, in case of discrete, there is summation. It is in case of continuous integration, minus infinity to infinity f of x dx. Similarly, variance is p of x equal to e of x square minus e of x whole square. So these are the contents. We did it. Now we will discuss few problems. Okay. So the first problem is, if f of x equal to kx e raised to minus x 0, x greater than 0 and 0 otherwise is a PDF of a random variable. Find k. So solution. So given we have f of x, that is PDF, is equal to k x e raised to minus x when k x greater than 0 and 0 otherwise. Now we want to find k. Since f of x is a PDF, we have the property. We already studied the property, right? This property, integral minus infinity to infinity f of x dx is 1. Okay. So we have the property integral minus infinity to infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. So now, which implies, so this can be split into integral minus infinity to 0. That means for x less than or equal to 0, the value is 0 dx plus integral 0 to infinity. For x greater than 0, it is kx e raised to minus x dx. So total probability is 1. So this quantity is 0. Now which implies I can take k outside and integral x e raised to minus x is x into integral e raised to minus x by minus 1 minus of integral derivative of x 1 integral of e raised to minus x 0 to infinity is equal to 1. So which implies k into x e raised to minus x divided by minus 1. Here there is minus and minus plus integral e raised to minus x is e raised to minus x minus 1 0 to infinity. So this is k into this is equal to 1. And if I put infinity as upper limit, we will get x e raised to minus infinity. So x e raised to minus infinity, that means x goes to infinity, e raised to minus infinity goes 0 very fast, so that will dominate. Therefore, infinity e raised to minus infinity minus 1 plus this is minus e raised to minus infinity minus of 0, this becomes 0 minus 1. Equal to 1. So e raised to minus infinity, e raised to minus infinity, this becomes 0. Therefore, k into minus minus 1, 1 equal to 1. So the answer is k equal to 1. So this is very easy, right? So in order to find the value of k, we will integrate. Okay. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me. So we will move to next problem. So here, solution. So the error involved in making a certain measurement is a continuous random variable x with PDF f of x equal to 0.09354 minus x square minus 2 less than x less than. Then I am now doing first one. Second one, compute p of x greater than 0. So p of x greater than 0 means integral 0 to infinity, because it starts from 0, 0 to infinity, f of x dx, which is equal to integral. Okay, so 0 to 2 and all other terms is 0. So it will be 0 to lower limit is 0 and up to 2, right? 2. 0.09375 into minus 4x square dx. So this is equal to 0.09375 into 4x minus x cubed by 3, 0 to 2. So this is 0.09375 into 8 minus 8 by 3. So that if you calculate this answer, the answer will be, if you calculate, 0.5. The answer. So similarly, you do this problem P of B. Okay, so I will delete all the B problem B. I have to calculate P of minus 1 less than x less than 1. So here, in case of continuous random variable, P of A less than x less than B is same as P of A strictly less than x less than strictly less than b. That is because p of x equal to a is always 0. That means probability at a point is always 0. So these are equal. So this is simply integral. But this is not in the case of discrete random variable. So integral 1 to minus 1 to 1 0.09375 O minus x square dx. You calculate this, I will give you the answer 0 point. So please verify this 0.6875. Similarly, okay. So please verify that answer. Similarly, we will do the last question, D. We have P of x less than minus 0.5 or P of x greater than 0.5. So, this is simply P of x less than minus 0.5 plus P of x greater than 0.5. So, this is integral minus infinity to minus 0.5 f of x dx plus integral 0.5 to infinity f of x dx. So this is equal to, so the value is always from minus 2. So this is simply minus 2 to minus 0.5. 0.09375 4 minus x square dx plus integral 0.5 to 2, because endpoint is 0.909375 4 minus x square. So please verify the answer. You do the problem and verify the answer. 0.6328. So this is the answer. So please do that problem and answer. And last problem. So today we will conclude by this problem. Okay. So, a continuous random variable has cumulative distribution function. There is one more problem. So, here cumulative distribution function has follows capital F of x equal to in the capital F of x, that is here given cumulative distribution function, capital F of x equal to 0 when x less than 1, and k into 1 x minus 1 all raised to 4 when 1 less than x less than 3, 0 when x greater than 3. Okay, so we have to do this problem. So first, this is solution for that. First of all, we know by definition capital f of x is p of x less than or equal to x, that is equal to integral minus infinity to x f of x dx. We have to find PDF. So PDF, capital F of x is integral of small f of x, therefore small f of x will be derivative of capital F of x. So probability density function is the derivative of probability distribution function in case of continuous random variable, only in case of continuous random variable. So therefore we have small f of x equal to d by dx of capital F of x, which implies small f of x is equal to derivative of 0, 0 when x less than 1, when x 1 less than or equal to x less than 3, derivative is of this is 4k x minus 1 all cube, and derivative of this. So therefore 4k, this is PDF, but we don't know what is k, so we will find k. So for that we know integral minus infinity to infinity f of x dx is equal to 1. So which implies here integral minus infinity, only the range is minus infinity to infinity f of x dx is equal to 1 implies integral minus infinity to 1 it is 0, and 3 to infinity 0, therefore only remaining is 1 to 3 4k x minus 1 all cube dx. So this is equal to 1, symbolize 4k into x minus 1 all raised to 4 by 4 1 to 3 equal to 1. Now if you calculate this, you will get 16k is equal to 1, therefore k equal to 1 by 16. So if you integrate this and put the values on to the limit, you will get 16. So the value k equal to 1 by 16, therefore our this become 1 by 4 into 1 by 16, 1 by 4. So this is the answer. So in order to find a PDF, from CDF, you just integrate that. Sorry, take derivative of CDF to find PDF. Now, last problem. A continuous random variable has PDF f of x equal to 3 plus 2x by 18, less than x, less than 4, 0, otherwise. Find mean and variance. So for that, so first we will find the mean equal to e of x equal to integral minus infinity to infinity x into f of x dx, which is equal to integral minus infinity to infinity, so here all other terms are 0, only 2 to 4, 3 plus x into 3 plus 2x by 18 dx is equal to is equal to, if you integrate that, you will get I can take 1 by outside, 1 by 18 outside, 1 by 18 outside, integrate, and 3x integral 3x square by 2 plus 2x square 2x cube by 3 0 to sorry 2 to 4. So that is equal to, if you put values limit, the answer will be 83 by 27. So just E of x is equal to 83 by 27. Now for finding variance of x, now we have to find out variance of x. E of x equal to E of x square minus E of x whole square, right? So V of x is equal to E of x whole square. So we have E of x is equal to 83 by 27. So this is already fine. Now we will find E of x square. E of x square is integral minus infinity to infinity x square f of x dx, which is equal to integral minus infinity, okay, minus infinity to infinity, here only it ranges from 2 to 4. I can take 1 by 18 outside, 2 to 4 x square into 3 plus 2x dx. Now this is equal to 1 by 18 integral 2 to 4 3x square plus 2x cube dx, 1 by 18 integral 3x square is equal to x cube by 3 plus x raised to 4 by 2, 2 to 4. So now, so that is equal to 1 by 18, x cube plus x raised to 4 by 2, 2 to 4. So by putting the limit, I'm not doing the calculation. By putting limit, you will get 176 by 18. So this is E of x square. Therefore, E of variance of x is equal to E of x square minus E of x all square, which is equal to 176 by 18 minus E of x is 83 by 27 all square. So this is answer will be 239 by 2729. So this is the answer. So this is very easy, and I will share few questions in your WhatsApp group. Try to do those problems. And you should submit assignments on Friday. So I have